Welcome back. I'm Haethal, studying in 12th in Sarvodaya Central Vidyalaya. So today, well, after a very long time, I'm here with a continuation of the previous topic, the seven ancient wonders of the world. I'm going to tell about the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. So, unlike the Lighthouse of Alexandria, which is not familiar to many people, this Hanging Gardens of Babylon is one thing that is familiar to all. Anyway, I would like to give some information regarding this. So before starting the topic, let me make one thing clear. All the information regarding the Hanging Gardens of Babylon is purely based on assumptions and circumstantial evidences. So it can change during the passing time. As mentioned before, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon is one of the seven ancient wonders of the world. As a fabled garden in the capital of the Neo-Babylonian Empire, it is filled with different kinds of trees, fruits, flowers, bushes, shrubs, etc. from different parts of the world. It also has an amazing feat of architecture, construction and a system of irrigation. It is the only wonder for which the location is not found until now. How do we know about the existence of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon? Historians put forward three theories regarding the existence of these gardens. First one is that they are purely mythical. Historians suggest that this is simply a legend which is passed from people to people and from generation to generation. Second one is that this Hanging Gardens of Babylon actually existed in Babylon but was eventually destroyed and hence there is no information. The third theory is that it is a well-planned garden built by the Assyrian king Sennacherib in the capital city of Nineveh beside the river Tigris. It is also said that these gardens were built by the Babylonian king Nebuchadnezzar II for his wife Amytis in between 500 and 600 BCE. It was built for his wife so that his wife will not miss her homeland Media. So, how was it constructed? The Hanging Gardens of Babylon was an amazing work of architecture. It was raised in a quadrangular platform and was 75 feet high. It had different layers which were supported by the stone columns and these layered balconies contained bitumen, reed and lead. But this Babylon was situated in a very high alluvial plain where there was no stone nearby their land. Then how did they get this stone to build the stone columns? Well, there is no answer for this question. As told earlier, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon had a well-elaborated irrigation system, so it is necessary to know about it. The Gardens of Babylon had a wide variety of plants such as Olea europaea, Cydonia oblonga, and Pistacia atlantica. It also had imported plants such as cedar, ebony, plum, willow, walnut, etc. So, it was necessary to have a well-elaborated irrigation system to water all these plants in that deserted area, right? Do you know that almost 82,000 gallons of water was needed to water all the plants in the Hanging Gardens of Babylon? Historians investigated hidden machines that were used for irrigation in the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. From that, the most interesting one was the Artemis screw. Why is it interesting? It is because Babylonians used this so-called Artemis screw almost 200 years before Archimedes actually inventing one. I guess this Hanging Gardens of Babylon is full of surprises. Why do at least some historians believe in the existence of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon? It is because even though there is no reliable first-hand information or an established location, there's tits and bits of sources regarding the information of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. For example, in a book called Babylonica, written in 280 BC, the historian Berossus had mentioned about the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. But this book was lost. Anyway, it was some rise in a later text. Well, there is no other reference regarding the Hanging Gardens of Babylon other than some poets mentioning it. Some archaeologists claim to prove the location of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Once, 14 large stone rooms with arched ceilings were found in the southern citadel of the Babylon by a German archaeologist, Robert Coldway. But other historians said that the river Euphrates was so far away from this preferred location and hence the irrigation was almost impossible. Again, in 2013, the Oxford historian Stephanie Dalle have claimed to found the location of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Do you know who Stephanie Dalle is? Stephanie Dalle is one of the very few historians who can decipher the cuneiform scripts and my favorite archaeologist. She claimed that this Hanging Gardens of Babylon existed near Tigris River in Nineveh. On the other hand, Sir Leonard Woolley suggested that these gardens existed within the walls of the Royal Palace of Babylon. I am not at all sure about the existence of these gardens. It sure is a wonder among the wonders. So everyone, please support me and please subscribe this channel. I wish you all a very happy autumn. Thank you and have a great day ahead.